This video is sponsored by patrons Felix Montezza, Joe Chavez, and Brandon Wiggins at patreon.com/amusementlabs. Get Discord perks, early access, and more through the link below. Alright, plutonium, check time circuits, on, flux capacitor, running, and lights. Hold on everybody, 88 miles an hour, here we come. Originally conceived in 1986, Back to the Future the Ride was an ambitious attraction challenging director Steven Spielberg and Peter Alexander to respond to the upcoming Star Tours in 1987. While Back to the Future had just been released, MCA, the owners of Universal during this time, were already set on creating a Back to the Future themed ride, but had several drawing board ideas on what to make. After development, one of the last two ideas was a long-stretch DeLorean roller coaster. Unfortunately, the technology of the time was not sufficient to create an indoor roller coaster that could tell a cohesive story while in motion, and therefore the coaster idea was shelved. MCA, Alexander, and Spielberg eventually landed on a never-before-seen system that would provide the rider throughput for a world-class park along with the personal experience of riding in a DeLorean. What they built was something that would not only rival Star Tours, but launch Universal Studios into the public eye as a destination park with cutting-edge attractions.
Why did I think of this before?
Announced in early 1989 as a coming addition to Universal Studios Florida, Back to the Future the Ride not only outpaced Star Tours on paper, but would leap past some of the park's own rides like Confrontation and Jaws the Ride that you can find out about in the iCard above. Later that year, a near-duplicate installation of the ride would be unveiled for Universal Studios Hollywood for a 1991 opening as well. Universal Studios Florida would open its gates in June 1990 with construction of the Institute of Future Technology, home to Back to the Future the Ride, already underway. By May 1991, the ride finally was ready and grand opened on May 2nd, 1991 to crowds of parkgoers. However, on the West Coast, things were far less ideal. Being in earthquake territory, the California version of the ride hit construction contract snags when the foundation was found to be off by an insane amount and therefore was deemed unusable, in addition for its need of seismic fittings. As a result, Universal Studios Hollywood lost its contribution to the ride's film production to the added construction costs before opening on June 12, 1993. Being a ride based on a futuristic sci-fi film, it only made sense to make Back to the Future the Ride a screen-based experience, and this ride went big. Seven-story Omnimax dome screen big.
This is the dome.
This is the dome. This is an 80-foot diameter, hemispheric dome, powder-coated aluminum, perforated, so it's acoustically transparent.
The Omnimax Theater is central to the ride's thrill. That curved screen, $16 million, 5-minute special effects spectacular, was shot sideways on 70mm film.
Unlike today's screen-based experiences, Back to the Future the Ride would utilize a combination of stop-motion animation and prop-based filming. Directed by Douglas Trumbull, it also used very few digital effects, providing a level of realism that CGI of the day could just not do. Scale models of 2015 Hill Valley, neighborhoods, caves, volcanoes, and a large 7-foot posable dinosaur that eats riders were all constructed just for the ride film.
Now, Hill Valley was not a computer simulation. Hill Valley was a gigantic model they had made of the city. This is boring, but I'll be finished in a minute.
No, I want to hear.
The queue of Back to the Future the Ride is a multi-story ascent to one of three levels. Riders ended up at an identical pre-show holding area where they are separated into four groups of up to eight riders while the premise of the ride unfolds. The ride's plot revolves around Biff breaking into the Institute of Future Technology and stealing Doc's DeLorean, tasking riders with traveling through time to chase and bump him back to the Institute. Riders are then directed either left or right to one of the building's two identical theaters with smaller rooms for a brief safety video. Here, riders are reminded how to load into the DeLorean, leaving their belongings off to the side of the car because they'll be back later, and rules like no eating or smoking. It was the 90s. The doors forward of riders swing open and they're let into the neighboring room, presented with the new convertible Mr. Fusion powered 8-person DeLorean time machine, ready to go with its gold wing doors open and dock over the PA beckoning riders in. The cars sit four across in two rows, with a single lap bar to restrain riders from standing. When Back to the Future the ride opened, it became the largest motion simulator ever built. The DeLorean's riders loaded into were, in reality, the state-of-the-art motion simulators of their time. Given the building's two theaters, it would be extremely inefficient just to have one screen for each car, taking only 8 riders at a time. To still provide the personal experience of riding in an 8-person DeLorean, Universal organized 12 DeLoreans per theater, with 3 on floor 1, 5 on 2, and 4 on 3. Riders, along with the car and its heavy doors, were mounted onto a frame that moved up and down and tilted forward, back, and side to side dynamically during the ride.
How does this move?
It's just sitting here.
This ride vehicle is sitting on top of a 4-axis motion base, which moves fore and aft, up and down in the Z-axis. It pitches, tilting forward and backward, and rolls.
The frame that the cars were bolted to had 3 double A-frame type hinges connected to the center of the car frame and onto the base of the motion system. These physical hinges secure the car and allow for the tilting and vertical motion. The cars were manipulated in these 3 directions by 3 hydraulic actuators connected using universal joints. The actuators were arranged with 1 under the front of the car and 2 under the back of the car on the left and right for stability. These hydraulic actuators are more reliable, precise, and powerful than pneumatic actuators, which helps with the ever-changing load of riders. However, to reduce weight, this linear sled system also slid the car out from the false back panel of the DeLorean, leaving everything behind the last row behind on the ground, making the setup more stable. But you don't see the other DeLoreans because the entire ride system added yet another layer of complexity, as this entire system was placed on top of its vertical lift system.
When the fog lifts, you're 8 feet up in one of 12 full motion vehicles.
The electronics and controls for the car were all connected to a branching computer system through an umbilical cable that safely hung down from the car. The ride used a hydraulic scissor lift, something you may be familiar with from construction equipment or other fields, to lift the rider cabin into the air. When the lights shut off, riders feel the DeLorean lurch forward as the vehicle slid out from the false back of the car. The rise from the pit was disguised as a DeLorean hovering from out of the garage before accelerating to 88 miles per hour, warping through time to Hill Valley in 2015, and then we fly after Biff, leading us on a crash course around the movie's iconic clock tower and beyond. The film mostly took place at night to mask the far edge of the screen. Riders would then travel back, shown as a barren landscape of ice, traveling in caverns and the rivers. We then travel forward with caves of molten lava and volcanic activity. Here, a dinosaur that was actually 7 feet tall in production ravages the area and captures us for a meal before spitting us out, because we're not food, obviously. Biff then cries out for us to save him, and we soon bump him, setting us all back to the Institute, crashing right through the building sign. Back to the Future the Ride was a resounding success on both coasts, pushing attendance when the parks needed the most and making Universal a genuine competitor in the industry. As many sci-fi movies go, the future eventually caught up with the ride, and it was officially announced to close in late 2007, after the popularity of the film franchise had dwindled. Not much was actually known about the future of the ride, and if it would just be demolished or if it would be rethemed. But soon after, it was announced a familiar cast from Springfield will call the Institute home very soon, featuring a plethora of technological upgrades that you can learn about in our other video about the Simpsons ride. And that's how Back to the Future the Ride worked. What other attractions would you like to see us cover next? Help us go further beyond the attraction by hitting subscribe and commenting down below. You can also support what we do with Early Access and more on Patreon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the parks.
I'm gonna throw up on a sick kid.